Hey guys, this is Ben with FCP. Today we're working on a 96 Volvo 850 turbo. We're going to be replacing the PCV kit. Let's get started. First, disconnect the negative terminal on your battery and tuck that aside. Using a T25 Torx bit, remove your throttle body cover. Using a 7mm socket or a flathead screwdriver, remove your upper intercooler pipe. Remove your throttle linkage. Set that aside. Remove your fresh air snorkel. Unplug your idle air control valve connection and throttle body sensor connection. Remove the vacuum lines from the vacuum tray and from the manifold. Using an 8mm socket, remove your injector wire clamp. Remove your injector cover simply by pulling up, set that aside, and unhook each injector. Using a 10mm socket, unbolt the fuel rail. Using a T25 Torx, remove your fuel line support bracket, as well as the rear support. Before removing the fuel rail with injectors, you need to remove the fuel pressure regulator vacuum line. Carefully pull up on the fuel rail, making sure the injectors stay in the rail. If you lose an injector, make sure you clean up the fuel quickly. Plugging the port with your finger, you can just pop the injector right back into the fuel rail. Give it a firm push. Using a T27 Torx bit, remove the spark plug cover. Underneath the intake manifold, there are two support brackets that are difficult to see. One for the dipstick tube. You want to remove that. Towards the back of the intake manifold, there's another support bracket, also a 12mm bolt. Remove that as well. If you feel around, it's just to the left of the starter. Pull your dipstick tube out. Set that aside. Using a 10mm socket, begin to remove the intake manifold bolts. What you want to do is remove all of the top row, but only loosen the bottom row. The intake manifold hangs off the lower bolts. You don't need to remove them all the way. That's enough. This bolt all the way on the end is a little tricky to get to. It is underneath the thermostat between the intake manifold and the thermostat housing. This one only needs to be loosened. Loosen up the last bolt. Remove the spark plug cover. And remove the upper PCV hose. With all the nuts and bolts loosened or removed, and the electrical connections and vacuum lines removed, you can lift the manifold up and out. Snake the PCV line through and remove the last hose at the very end. Get up and out as best as you can. Set that aside. Next, remove the intake manifold support bracket using a 12 millimeter socket. Using a 10 millimeter socket, remove the left and right PCV box bolts. Cut the clamp off of the PCV box and remove the upper hose. If you need extra space, you can unplug your knock sensor. Cut the last hose clamp. And remove the box from the block. Lastly, remove the drain hose from the block. Next, what you want to do is inspect these ports for excessive oil buildup. As you can see, this one is not that bad, but sometimes it can be up to halfway full with dried up, built up gunk. And you want to clean all that out, make sure your system is free flowing. Over on the intake side, remove the vacuum line. Remove the last clamp from the PCV system. You can use a screwdriver to spread that clamp open and break the grip. Pull this whole thing out. Next, slide the PCV hard pipe out. This is the dry oil buildup that I was talking about. It'll fill these hoses up and prevent flow of air. Remove the intake manifold gasket by pulling the bolts the rest of the way out. We're using a Victor Rains intake manifold gasket and genuine Volvo parts for the rest of the kit. Insert the lower bolts a few turns. Insert the new drain gasket. Pulling the breather elbow off will make it easy to slide the assembly back towards the intake. slide the elbow back over the hard pipe and pop that down over the PTC fitting with a hose clamp. And slide on the vacuum line. With the tubes and hose clamps in place, slide the box back onto the block. Replace the bolts. Snug that down lightly. Clamped on all the hose clamps. Don't forget to plug in your knock sensor. Connect the last elbow and clamp that down. Replace your intake manifold bracket bolt. Tighten that down. Next, replace the last vacuum line for the breather onto the end of the intake manifold. Snake the head vent hose back through your intake manifold. Now you can set the intake manifold back onto the bolts. You put a hose clamp on top and crimp that down, removing the spark plug wires helps to gain some space. Make sure you click them down. Now you can start replacing the upper intake manifold bolts. And tighten them all down. Now's a good time to replace your dipstick tube O-ring. Slide that into place and replace the bolt. Tighten it using a 12 millimeter socket. And remember the last bolt for your intake manifold bracket back behind the starter. Replace your spark plug cover. Replace your fuel rail. Put a little bit of silicone on each of these lower O-rings so that they go in nice and smooth. And if you ever have to pull them out again, they should pop out of the manifold instead of the fuel rail. Make sure you don't get any on the tip, just the O-ring itself. Slide them back into the manifold. giving them a thumb push. Replace the fuel rail bolts back into the manifold. Plug your injector wires back in. And replace your fuel rail cover. Tighten your injector wire clamp. Using a 10 millimeter socket, replace the rear fuel line connector. And your T25 for the upper fuel rail bracket. Replace your idle air control valve plug and your throttle body position sensor plug underneath, as well as all the vacuum lines. Replace your upper intercooler pipe and hose clamps. Replace your throttle cable and throttle body cover. Replace your snorkel. Remember to reconnect your negative battery terminal. All right, guys, there you have it, the Volvo 850 PCV system replacement. If you have any questions, please call FCP, and thanks for watching.